was by intent Pan-Africanist. At least he stood for something, although he had terrible economic politics, because Pan-Africanism of any sort without sharp radical economic politics means nothing. At least he stood for something. I don't understand when they say Boini's voice was shut out. What was his voice? What is it that he represented? What was he all about? Other than him being afraid that the Kuma's Pan-Africanism spread through the entire West Africa and dislodge Tutsis like him. That's one. Two, you're talking about the necessary friction. Now, I don't want to project my